happily retired now.
Hooray for you.
Happily retired now.
What you gonna do?
There's books to read and golf to play, naps to take, have fun all day. You're happily retired.
Well, before we get started, I wanted to take a minute so that you could look at this pretty interesting group of people. Erin reminded me that I'm a Johnny Complete, as she said. I don't necessarily feel that way, but if I might be political for a moment, if you look around the room, the people that are in this room have had a substantial impact on what Hopkinton is today. And I don't know how we can replicate this group.
It would be very difficult.
It's on its way in a different direction. And we also are not, we talked about what kind of program this should be, and we decided we didn't want this to be a roast, because we needed to be funny enough. But you know, I'm feeling it kind of sad myself tonight, because whether it is like it or not, there are people in this room that have put, I don't know, the group that just retired 100 and some odd years of service into the community. I don't think you can really replace that, but we'll see what we can do to perk the energy up a little bit. But I wanted you to see this crowd before we get started.
What a wonderful crowd.
And you'll have a shot later, how's that? You're gonna make this program work, by the way, so get prepared, all of you. But we have a presentation to begin with, and I'd like to invite our distinguished Senator Karen Spilka up for some remarks and a presentation.
Tim.
Okay. What a great crowd. And it's all for you, Maureen. It is. And this week, a little week and a half, has been pretty special with retirements. Hard for Hopkinton, hard for the residents of Hopkinton, with the chief retiring, congratulations. With Jerry leaving, congratulations. And with you leaving, the town will change, definitely. I know when I first started representing Hopkinton, at this point it blows me away, it was 11 years ago, but in walking into town hall and in talking to people and meeting with people, you may not remember, but you were among the first persons that I met. And the two points that I want to make that I felt immediately, that in talking to people here and around Hopkinton, when you ask about Maureen, the two things that are mentioned mostly are, the word that comes to mind is respect. The respect that you give to everybody in the town that came into the office, and the respect that people gave back to you because of it. It was an incredibly service-oriented office. Anybody warm, caring, which you can't substitute, you can't replace, to have a place for people to come who had questions, and sometimes they were difficult times people are going through, to come to this office. But you gave everybody the warmth, the caring, and the respect, and usually the information that they needed to be helpful. That is a pretty amazing task as well. But you also look at the sense of community that Maureen, over the years, as talk about the fabric of a community and weaving together the different pieces and all that has been done. Casting a spell, you brought a sense of humor to the Board of Selectmen, and being chair, all that you did. I can't compete with these pictures. But I just want to thank you, because I know you're not going far, that you still will remain active. Hopefully we'll see you. I really do like the cake. I give credit to whoever set the time clock with all of the different comments and activities. I particularly like the 7 o'clock hour. That's, for those that have not seen the cake, that's the margarita hour. Hopefully I may be able to come and join you at some point at times. But thank you so much. And I have a Senate citation. Do you want to come up? I can give it to you. Maureen said she took her heels off, so she won't be so. I put my heels on so I'd be taller. I don't normally wear them. So this is a state Senate citation, I'll read it. Official citation: be it known that the Massachusetts Senate hereby extends its congratulations to Maureen Dwinnell in recognition of the joyous occasion, because it is joyous, yes, for you anyway, of your retirement and your years of dedicated service as Hopkinton's treasurer. And be it further known, the Massachusetts Senate extends best wishes for continued success, and the citation is signed by Senate President Stan Rosenberg, William Welch, the Clerk of the Senate, myself, Karen Spilk, as Hopkinton State Senator, and it's dated January 7th, 2016. Congratulations. Representative Carolyn Dykema, who was unable to join us. She had a family commitment, but there's a similar citation from the House of Representatives as well.
Thank you.
Congratulations. Thank you. I have to go on a meeting with a group of about 50 Boy Scouts. So.
Picture of the two selectmen with the witches' hats. Some of you probably remember when that part.
That's what
they thought. That's the There was a point in Hopkinton's history when you remember we had three selectmen. And it was the only town in the Commonwealth where three women were sitting on the board of selectmen at the same time. And I remember that I was there that night when the witches' hats came on. That's a pretty famous photograph. And I think the one of the people in the room that lived through that experience, in the experience with you as a member of the Board of Selectmen, was Mary Harrington. And I think we need to get her up here to talk about that.
I'm a townie.
Yeah.
How's that?
Yeah.
Well,
I'm sorry, I fell into flagging Tim by telling him that you're going to come lately, but that's exactly what he is. Great job, he's Mark, Maureen. Maureen and I served on the Board of Selectmen together. And one of the other women, we were the only all-female Board of Selectmen in the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. And I looked up one night and there was a television camera in my face. And the guy came up to me and he said, "Oh, you must be a women's liver." And I said, "No, but I've always been a liberated woman, thanks to my husband." So Brian and I go back a long ways, go back to when your father was on the Board of Assessors, and she lived on College Rock Road. And we had a lot of fun. We were both selectmen at the time of the 100th running of the Boston Marathon. And I said to the director, I said, I'm not going to vote to give you a permit to run the marathon unless you promise to take Maureen and I to the finish line. I said, we've always looked at Hopkinton and seen it start, but we've never seen you finish. So Dave McGilvery said, "That's no problem." He said, "We're taking it by helicopter." I said, "Oh, that is great." And Big Mo says, "I'm not riding the helicopter." So at 5 o'clock in the morning of the 100th running, we were met by the race director, Guy Moss, and he introduced us to this very tall state trooper. I mean, he had to be tall. Maureen was tall and I'm short. So he said, "You see that cruiser park road in front of the center school?" He said, "The minute the last runner goes over the finish line, the start line," he said, "you and Maureen make a beeline over to the center school and get in that cruiser." And I'm thinking to myself, "Oh, this ought to be fun." Well, it was a good thing that we did, because they didn't know how to get to 495. So we got in the cruiser with Guy Moss, the director, and this very tall trooper. I don't even remember what his name was. And we take off down Nash Street. So that's like never, never been for this trooper. So we end up going down Ash Street, and out to Chestnut Street, and out to Hayden Row, and over to the Milford exit, and we were on 495. And the next thing I know, I look at the speedometer, and we're going 100. And we're at the 128 exit ramp, our toll booth, and the guy at the toll taker is waving us through with the blue lights going. So we ended up to see the finish of the Boston Marathon, which we had never done before. And poor Paul Phipps had agreed to drive us home. Well, I had a little bit too much wine to drink that day. And I fell asleep in the back of Paul Phipps' car. But we had a chance to see it finish, which I did in the two following years with my grandchildren, which was quite an experience, because when you see it start, we had never seen it finish. And we also were able to attend the pre-marathon event that Mayor Menino sponsored. And Tim was there. And we left my husband chatting with some people that he probably didn't know. And Tim and I demolished the shrimp bar that was there. But I have a nice picture hanging on the wall at the house from Tom Menino that says, you started it and we finished it. To go back to Maureen, she has served as a public servant in this town for many, many years. She had one of the toughest jobs being the tax collector. When people would come and say, you know, I really can't pay my taxes. But Maureen always was available to make some accommodation with them to set up a payment plan so they could continue to stay in their home. And that was very important then, and it's even more important now. Maureen is a real people person, and she served this community far and above what was necessary. And we will miss her. I work up there now during tax time on the senior relief program, and it's been quite an experience for me. It gives them a helping hand, and it gives me an opportunity to see people who I haven't seen for a long time. But Maureen will be sadly missed, not only by me, but those of us here and the community as well. She's done a great job, and we wish you a happy and healthy retirement.
Can't resist this, but there are people in Hope elected office at the moment that would be wise to spend some time with Maureen and Mary, because one of the things that they did, I think you can't argue with this, is you knew where they stood. You may not have liked them, but you absolutely knew where they stood. And that's something that we ought to focus on, and we ought to get people to replicate. Now, there are some other people in the room that we'll let you volunteer as opposed to calling out, but we'd be remiss if we didn't have Dr. Duffy, who also has had a long-standing relationship with Maureen, come up and reflect a little bit. Dr. Duffy.
Good evening, tomorrow's gathering, and Maureen deserves a very dear. A little change of pace. Frank Sinatra had a song that's very appropriate, I think. Back in the days of Broadway, the production of Pal Joey, and his song was, If I Could Write a Book. And I think that it should be, if Maureen could write a book, we would have some stories. But I've been saying over the years, in town government in Hopkinton, it's all about the people. And heaven knows that Maureen had a relationship politically and in municipal government that was long and unique and varied, sometimes contentious, but it was very, 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 very interesting. And there was one event that happened. I'm just going to tell us one story. And I epitomize everything I think of our relationship. That maybe it was 10 years ago. And why I remember this, it seems so so important to me at the time, and to, I keep recalling this story, but it's so typical, that I wanted to, I think at the time I was on the Appropriation Committee, about 10 years ago, Maureen was the chairman of the Board of Selectmen, and I had some fiscal issue that, no surprise, I was concerned about, and a lot of those, and I wanted to present it to the Board of Selectmen. So I appeared before the Board of Selectmen, Maureen was the chairman, and I said I was information about the fiscal policy issue, and she said to me, she says, I will not allow you to present that to the Board. And so we went, and I was trying to explain why I thought it was important that I should do this, and that she should let me do it, and we went round and round for about 10 minutes, until finally one of the other selectmen I forget which one said, oh, let him say what he wants to say. So I did. And everybody then looked at Maureen and what is going to be her reaction. And her reaction was, gee, that wasn't so bad. And that kind of epitomized the way we went back and forth many, many years. And it's been quite an experience. And it's, as I can say, it's all about people. And here are two people who we did work together. And I think we produced a lot of good for the town, and the town profited, I think, by our relationship, if you will, because we went back and forth, and Maureen just did a marvelous job as treasurer collector. It's a very difficult job, very demanding, and it will be a real challenge to find anyone who can even close measure up to her. Thank you very much, Maureen.
Are you surprised by all of this? These guys, you are. Who's next? Who's next? I'm looking at somebody that needs to. We need to get up here. We'll let them volunteer. We'll let them volunteer. All the volunteers. Mike Shepard.
What can you say? Maureen is like Mrs. Hopkinton. And although she's a couple years younger than me, I can remember when we were kids, and Maureen lived on the other side of town, at Pike College Rock, and I lived at the Capitol in Woodville. a lot of the old time to say, geez, I wish the town was like it used to be. And growing up in town, yeah, it was great. For a kid, it was super. You know, we'd go after school, we'd go home, Freddie Harris and I would get our 22s, and we'd go up behind the Walnut Grove with the dumplers and we'd shoot rats. I guess the kids don't do that today. That was great stuff. But I think the town has grown a lot, and those small part due to Maureen's work and Mary's work, and we have a lot to thank for where we are today to these people because they work so hard. A lot of the other towns around us grew way too fast, and they grew way too big, way too soon, and we didn't do that. The old timers kind of took care of us. We got South Street, it's helped us incredibly. The growth has been relatively smart and relatively slow, and the town is in a great place, and I think it's no small part of Maureen's hard work. And when I was a selectman, there was only three people that I really looked forward to that I wanted to emulate when I was a selectman, and one was Maureen, one was Mary, and the other one was Hank Burdette. And people get out there and they're able to say what they want. There's no bullshit, and that's the way Maureen was, and that's what I've come to respect. And I thank you for your service to the town. And Red, thank you for Maureen.
Mary mentioned the marathon, and both Maureen had a strong hand in particularly around 100. But I think Dorothy Farragher will attest to this. If it weren't for the work of the community leaders in the marathon committee, the Hopkinton would lose its footprint around the marathon, would shrink. And I know they spend, Dorothy spends a lot of time with her committee making sure that that Hopkinton's part in the marathon doesn't shrink. And we, that's another thing we probably ought to rededicate ourselves to. I'm fond of saying that the spirit of the marathon lives here, resides here. It was transferred here actually from Greece. And we lend it out once a year to the people in Boston, but we take it back. So thank you, Dorothy, and your committee for the work that you do. All right. Anne.
Hi, I don't need a
microphone. Oh, yes, you do. You know, one of the things that's interesting is to have an e-cam here because they're going to replay this, and those messages that you're hearing are going to be played back to the greater community, which I think is a message that needs to be heard loud and strong.
Like Mike, I grew up in Hopkinton too, and was new Maureen forever and ever. And her father tricked her into going to marry it.
Yes.
He said he made a deal for one year. And she ended up staying for four. But when she got her license, Carol Brown and Maureen and I drove together. And she had a great trip. Carol and I lived across the street from each other. So when she picked us up, she had all three cigarettes lit. From Hayden Row to Marion High, if you puffed quick, you could get 2 in. Picked us up and you know, it's the usual. So what'd you do this weekend? Oh, I put a kit in. I said, a kit? What do you mean a kit? She put a four on the floor in her car, in her Ford. She's so talented. And she became a talented person. Well, once growing up, you know, she didn't slow down. She never slowed down. She was willing to do what it took to stay faithful to her profession. And you had a couple things, but the most recent one was treasurer for us, and we really appreciate it and I admire you for all your work. Thank you.
This will be interesting. So because Eric's side followed the lead of the Board of Selectmen that Maureen helped to set. Eric Sonny.
Hi, Maureen.
Hey.
Happiness is being a chairman of the Board of Selectmen following the most successful Board of Selectmen we ever had. Maureen served 6 years, five of them as chairman. She ran the town. As in those days, there was no norm. All departments answered to the Board of Selectmen, and the chairman typically took over the role of being the town manager. Even though Ted Kosak was there and he was phenomenal, Maureen, I know what she did. Well, when I wandered into the building, we had a situation. Maureen and the accounting department weren't getting along very well. None of the numbers added. Heidi blamed Maureen, Maureen blamed Heidi. And I said, well, this is easy. I'll just talk to both of them and it'll solve itself. So I did. And they both said exactly the same thing. Yes, sir, we understand, by God, we love each other. And I thought, I'm in worse shape than I thought I was. Long story short, they both pledged that they would fix the problem. About a month later, Gary Doherty came to me and said, hey, boss, you got a problem between accounting and treasurer. And I said, oh, great, this is wonderful. So there wasn't a lot of sense in talking to a county. I couldn't get through to those people. But Maureen and I sort of shared the same insight as to how the system worked. So I went down to Maureen and I said, Maureen, let me ask you a question. If you were chairman of the Board of Selectmen, and this situation existed while you were chairman, what would you do? And she said, let me think about it. So I got a letter from Maureen. And basically she said, I would give me one more chance, and if I didn't fix it, I'd fire me. I looked at it, I said, I'm not firing you, don't be ridiculous. But the long story short is she fixed it, like she fixed everything else she touched when she saw a problem. And I think all of you here agree with me that we were honored and blessed to have Maureen Dwinnell with us. Thank you, Maureen.
Another retiree.
Maureen, you should come on. I have had the pleasure of working with Maureen for almost 20 years. And I am glad accounting in the treasurer's office learned
with
how
to
play.
I'm glad.
Thank you for everything. Thank you for everything you taught me. Congratulations. Thank you.
Maureen, your daughter's going to buy you a gift tomorrow. I'm not supposed to tell you what it is, so just so you know. I'm going to surprise all these people by the contribution. I just did want to mention two things that I really respect about you and working with you is when you sat out in the front office with me, people would stop by and they'd always ask for your help, whether it was your resident, retiree, or employee. And you always stop what you were doing and help them. And, wow, she really gives her time and all your knowledge and your help and everything that stopped by. And the other thing is your personality. A lot of energy in our office, and that's gone now, and maybe even Stuart and I still here, but on Mondays, boy, I really miss Maureen. So, the personality is definitely
something. Come on, Liz!
Well, I've only known Maureen probably for a year and a half now, but that year and a half has made my life a lot better. Maureen has sure brought a lot of joy to my life. We've had a lot of fun, even when I disagree with Maureen and I tell her, do I have to stand on a chair and yell at you?
Just tell her to sit down like I do.
I go, Janet, there she goes.
She's
giving me that look.
So Maureen has been a great asset to the town, and I've really enjoyed working with her.
I don't know where to start, but I've been working with Maureen in the town for 9 years. Maureen has taught me a lot. We've had a lot of great times at the town, and that's why I left before, because I heard she was leaving, so I had to beat her to the punch. Maureen, seriously, we're going to miss you. We miss you already. You've taught me so much, and thank you for letting me work with you. You'll be missed.
So to share this with you, they all of you have contributed to what will be either a some sort of technology, but that's what they're going to go shopping for tomorrow. Is a laptop?
Tim,
no, we didn't give it away. Why? What the hell? Remember, you always tell the truth. That's what you told me.
I know.
Anybody else?
He's going to tell you about his thorn.
It's not the principal tonight, Maureen.
Oh, it isn't?
I'll tell you, I'm the least qualified individual in this room to be holding this mic. Everybody who's spoken about Maureen has known Maureen for many years. I've only known Maureen for 7 years, and what I can share with you, based on the comments that I've heard tonight, is that there are people who believe that it takes a village to raise a child. What I've learned in the last 7 years is that perhaps it may take Maureen to raise a community. On behalf of Town Hall employees, Maureen, we want to thank you for raising us. We want to thank you for raising us in many ways. You've laid the foundation for the work that we do. Your many years of experience and many years of service and inspiration to all of us. But most importantly, I will never forget those wonderful moments that you and I have spent where you have told me, Norman, don't do it. You'll be crazy to do that. And most importantly,
I'd say, what are you, nuts?
Exactly. Most importantly, I want to thank you personally for showing me what a wonderful family you have. Most of you may not know it. Maureen has kept an open invitation to me and my family to spend as much time as I can with her family. And the moments I've spent with your family have brought joy to my family. Again, on behalf of Town Hall, we wish you a wonderful, healthy and successful retirement. Thanks, Maureen.
He's what?
He really wants to work with Red on a farm.
There's some wonderful cake over in this corner, coffee in this corner, and I think we should give Maureen the last word. What do you say?
Yeah. First of all, I'd like to thank everyone for coming here. I haven't seen some of you in a long time. It's been wonderful. Got to talk with everybody and talk about old times and bring up old stories. And I'd like to take this opportunity to thank Diane Hendrickson, Michelle Broda, Tim Kildow for putting this event together, and to thank the community for putting up with me for 26 years, 8 months, and 6 days. Most of all, I want to thank my family who has put up with my career for 26 years, 8 months, and 6 days. There's a lot of times that I should have been there and I wasn't because I had to work. But I think I raised them to be the same way, because now they can't be there because they're working. But I love them all, especially my husband, Red. And I love this community. I was born and brought up here. My heart will always be in Hopkinton. Thank you.
And tell the boss to take a leap, a flying leap. Because you're happily retired today.